Please subscribe, like, and share. It really helps us out. And of course, if you have any questions, comment below, and we will answer you as soon as we can. Welcome to this video in our series on IGCSE Business Studies. This is Unit 1, Part 2. In today's lesson, we will be learning about the classification of businesses. If you haven't seen our previous videos, click on the card above.
Let's look at the primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. Businesses can be classified into three sectors. First, the primary sector. This involves the use and extraction of natural resources. Examples include agricultural activities, mining, fishing, wood cutting, and oil drilling. Next, the secondary sector. This involves the manufacture of goods using the resources from the primary sector. Examples include automobile manufacturing, steel industries, and cloth production. Finally, the tertiary sector. This consists of all the services provided in an economy. This includes hotels, travel agencies, hair salons, and banks. Up until the mid-18th century, the primary sector was the largest in the world, as agriculture was the main profession. After the Industrial Revolution, more countries began to become more industrialized and urban, leading to a rapid increase in the manufacturing sector. This was due to industrialization. Nowadays, as countries are becoming more developed, the importance of the tertiary sector is increasing, while the primary sector is diminishing. The secondary sector is also slightly reducing in size. This is due to deindustrialization, compared to the growth of the tertiary sector. This is due to the growing incomes of consumers, which raises their demand for more services like travel and hotels.
Finally for today, the private and public sector. First, the private sector. This is where private individuals own and run business ventures. Their aim is to make a profit, and all costs and risks of the business are undertaken by the individual. Examples are Nike, McDonald's, and Virgin Airlines. Next, the public sector. This is where the government owns and runs business ventures. Their aim is to provide essential public goods and services. Examples are schools, hospitals, and police. In order to increase the welfare of their citizens, they don't work to earn a profit. It is funded by the taxpaying citizens' money, so they work in the interest of these citizens to provide them with services. An example is the Indian Railways, is a public sector organization owned by the government of India. In a mixed economy, both the public and private sector exists. Thank you for watching our video. Please like, subscribe and share. And comment below so we can clarify things for you.